Hi, everybody. Welcome back. My name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com with a tutorial that is part of a playlist, and it's the Parent's Guide for Google Classroom. Today, we're going to focus on communication. So there's a lot of different ways to communicate in Google Classroom. First, teacher to student. Second, teacher to the entire class. Third, student to the entire class. Fourth, student to teacher. And fifth, student to student. So let's show you how all of these work. Obviously, when the teacher is sharing stuff with the classroom, the assignments, that goes out to the whole class. There's a communication back and forth, and that will show up in your stream here. So this is just in a comment section here in the stream. And so the student can reply back to the teacher, and that can go back and forth, and all that information is saved, right? So this will go back and forth as a comment there. Now, in classwork, teachers can leave comments or suggestions or notes in the actual assignment itself. And then you'll see right here that shows up as a little comment here. Let's click on this assignment. So there's one comment. So if I click on that comment, this is the student leaving a comment. The teacher can also leave a comment back on that same kind of feed in those individual assignments. Now, when we click on people, the student has the ability to email the teacher, and the teacher has the same view. They can email the student. And we'll talk a little bit more about notifications and alerts and settings in the next video. But here, if I'm the student or if your child wants to email the teacher, you could click on this right here and it will pull up a dialog box in their district email. And you can see here, right, that has my email in the subject line. And then he could type an email and send that email directly from Google Classroom. So he does not need to go back into Gmail to send that to his teacher. That can also be done student to student. Why would you want to email student to student? Well, if you had a project that students were working on, right? As students get older in middle and high school, we have projects that especially now, right, where projects are being done at home or in groups. Offline, right, or at home, they can communicate that way. They can also communicate, right, again, in the stream here, and they can ask questions to the entire class. Hey, I'm working on this assignment. Is anybody home that wants to meet up in online and go through this together? They can do groups. Now, the teacher can also set up groups as well. So those are the five different ways that you can communicate in Google Classroom. Again, this is part of a longer series or a playlist on YouTube named A Parent's Guide to Google Classroom. If you found value, if this helped you or your child, I'd ask that you subscribe, like, share with other members of your family or school or class or district. If you have any questions, you can go ahead and leave a comment below and jump over to the next video where we're going to talk about settings and alerts. Again, thank you for stopping by. I love you. I appreciate you. And I'm glad that you're here.